Hi there, today on Typical Books, I'm going to be talking about The Haunting of Gillespie House by Darcy Coates. Now, The Haunting of Gillespie House is a 2015 book by Darcy Coates, and it's very small. It's a self-published, and I believe she still self-publishes, but has registered as a publisher in her own right, I believe. She does do a mix. She's a hybrid author, as far as I can tell, that does publish traditionally and self-publishing and with small houses, big houses. So yeah, she's kind of becoming a bit of a hero of mine as far as writing craft goes. Now, this particular book is, as I said, very slim. So it was a nice, quick, easy read. And I'll always use Murs from Harpies in the Trees term of a creepy, cozy book, because that's exactly what Darcy Coates offers us. I've also used Murs scoring, the book scorer from her page. So if you're not already following Harpies in the Trees, definitely do so. And thank you for coming up with that amazing spreadsheet. I'm a spreadsheet sucker, and I guess I've just not been as determined to come up with something as perfect, but I always do want to give some sort of out of 5 score, or an out of 10 score would probably be a little more definitive. But the scoring method of having it out of 3 gives certain aspects of a book, like, is it creepy enough? Yes, no, maybe, you know, yes, no, 50-50. That's sort of how I'm thinking of it. So it takes a lot of the thinking out of scoring a book, because I'd just give everything 5 out of 5 if I read it, and 0 if I didn't. Like, that's kind of bad. But thank you again for devising that, because this is one of the first ones I'm going to use that table, and I'd like to use it going forward so that I can subscribe a star method. I also do other book reviews that are, sometimes they don't make it on this channel, but sometimes they're ghostwritten as well, and they often do ask for a star rating of some sort, and I'm just not good at doing that. So anyway, Elle finds herself in a haunted house that is the stuff of dreams. This is a haunted house that has been modernized on one hand, yet has all of the remnants of its former glory shoved up into the attic. And that to me is just, it's every little girl's haunted house dream, right? Some houses breathe. Elle is thrilled to spend a month minding the beautiful Gillespie property. More than an hour's drive from the nearest town and surrounded by forests, the aging mansion is ideal for someone seeking solitude. But things start to go very wrong very quickly. Elle discovers a crumbling graveyard nestled in the woods. It contains a generation of the house's residents, all with an identical year of death. Scratching at the walls, slamming doors, whispers in the night, a locked room. As Elle explores deeper into the house, she begins to unravel the property's dark and dangerous history. At its center is Jonathan Gillespie, a tyrannical cult leader and the house's original owner. And as Elle soon learns, just because he's dead doesn't mean he's gone. Now, this includes the short story crawl space on which this book was set. Now, one thing I like is its length, if I haven't said 3 times already, but it couldn't have contained anything more. You know, this story is an expanded version, a very different version from the short story contained with this as well. So it is a very different story, but there isn't any more story to tell. And I really do applaud an author. I mean, you can write a Kleenex box sized book if that's the story that is in you that needs to get out in its entirety. You can also write a 20,000 word novelette, too short to be a novella, too long to be a short story, something like that, if that's the story that needs to get out. And that's where Haunting of Gillespie House seems to sit, is somewhere in that novella, novelette sort of range. Now, this reminded me a lot of Darling, starring Lauren Ashley Carter. If you dig this lone girl in a weird house with strange, unexplainable things happening to her, and a maybe somewhat unreliable narrator sort of thing going on, whether it's the house kind of driving her nuts, or she comes with a little bit of a touched frame of mind, or the house owners themselves, or what? There's a little bit of that, more so in Darling, of course. So if you like that lone girl in an unexpected haunted or somewhat haunted scenario, I definitely seek that film out. Now, this isn't really the top of the pile as far as Darcy Coates books goes, but I enjoyed it very, very much. I had a lot of fun with this. I like some of her newer stuff. And of course, that goes to say, like, when an author is is growing and maturing. Their older work is definitely getting better and better and better as it goes on. Like I'd said previously about Grady Hendrix, if We Sold Our Souls was not as good as Horror Store, there'd be something wrong there, right? So her more recent work is much better. And there's more recent work that seems to be even more sinister than I want to get to soon. Now, I enjoyed the atmosphere of this very much, this old mansion in the woods. And it not only reminded me of growing up at an old farmhouse myself with a lot of these sort of elements in the house, it also reminded me of Lovecraft's work. And not from the mythos angle, because Lovecraft seems to be a very different type of writer to me than he is to other people. But this sort of growing claustrophobia, this unreliable narrator that becomes birthed within somebody who at one point had been 100% reliable or came to us as somebody who we would judge as a person of sound mind and body, and we even begin to doubt that as we go on through the book. Now this is a lot less purple in prose than something like that. It's not the most eloquently written book. It's very utilitarian, but it's not quite like YA or Goosebumps level of writing. It's just a lot more fun. It clips along. It's somewhat casual, although not being trendy. And I really like that balance that Coates strikes in a lot of her work. So with the book scorer, this got 77 out of 114, which sounded dire at first, but then looking at it, that boils down to 4 out of 5, which is maybe a little higher than I would have suspected, but it sounds about right to me. It's not perfect by any means, but it is super fun. I had a great time with it. It's a very light read, and it did its job as far as entertaining me in that creepy, cozy way. Haunted houses, graveyards, cults, history, time jumping, all contained within a very short sit. Oh yeah, I enjoyed it very much. So if you've read anything that is really similar, let me know. If you're currently reading anything really similar, or if you've read The Haunting of Gillespie House, let me know in the comments below, and make sure that you have an ooky spooky day. The Haunting of Gillespie House by Darcy Coates. It is a typical book.